doors in our lives, and sometimes we go to open them, and they open rather easily. Sometimes we go, and they're locked. And we jiggle, and we jiggle, but we need a key to open it. During life, we go over the threshold, back and forth, but eventually we close the door that is behind us. Let us pray. Gracious and glorious God, we just thank you for the joy and the wonder of your Savior, our Savior child. Thank you for the gift this Christmas and throughout all the year, that we receive you and we love you. And oh gosh, Lord, thank you for that love that you came down at Christmas time. So may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be that bring you glory, my rock and my redeemer. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. This weekend between Christmas and New Year's is known as the Hinge Sunday, because we remember the past year and all that has happened, and we look forward to what the new year may come. So there's a swing time that we're dealing with in this time between Christmas and New Year's. The stories we tell and have can be symbolized in this door, and that's what we're going to do today. We enter and pass through and close many doors on this journey. And in the scripture today, Jesus was entering a new door. See, Jesus' family had prepared themselves to go to Jerusalem for the Feast of Passover. And by law, everyone was required at a certain distance to go ahead and come to Jerusalem to celebrate this feast. Thus, why we read that they came to the city every year. On this year, the scripture relates how Jesus is transitioning into adulthood, entering a new door, or a new part of his journey. While the rest of the caravan of the people return to Nazareth, Jesus remains. Jesus remains in Jerusalem. He enters the temple area, a place of worship. Okay? Now, during this Passover time, the greatest rabbis in the land are already there and assembled to teach and discuss great truths among themselves, and of course, one of the topics would be the Messiah. Now, Jesus was absorbed in this open debate for 3 days. Now, there's some significance to this 3 days that Luke refers to, because it refers to and implies the upcoming resurrection of Jesus. This story is about Jesus' human development and growing awareness. Notice how Luke describes the people as being astounded by the boy's understanding. It was not so much his youth, but the depth of his wisdom that astounded the teachers. Can you imagine what they thought years down the road? Oh, that was Jesus. That was the Messiah. Jesus entered at this point a new door. There is somewhat of a natural occurring of evolution between a parent and a child relationship, a time of independence, but also obedience. After being questioned where he was with his parents, a new path is set forth in public identification of his father. It's not Joseph. It's his heavenly father. This is identification that Jesus truly is the Son of Man. The passage portrays the incarnation. Jesus is the Son of God. His Father indeed is God and not Joseph. Indeed, Jesus realized that the one from whom the temple stands is uniquely his Father. You know, John Wesley, when teaching on this scripture, mentions how Jesus, being perfect, continues to grow into perfection. So all of us pure Christians, we have hope. We can continually also grow towards perfection. We continue to grow and be molded and shaped, and we have hope. Now the scripture ends by Mary treasuring all these things in her heart. She too realized this was a new season, and this was a new door that they were about to enter. Not just for Jesus, but also for her. Mary, in the unknown, painfully knows that Jesus is yet to walk through the many unknown doors. So at this time, we are entering new doors also. We remember and we're thankful for the year that has just been. But we're also looking forward to the entering the unknown territory, going and instead of turning back and clinging to the known, we're going to go venture forward into the unknown. So think about that as a door image. How many times do we approach a door during a day? And we can stand on this side and know what's happening. We've been here. We're living in this. Or we can face and start to open the door to the unknown. How scary is that for you? Is it one where we deal with, we stop at doors? Sometimes we just don't go in. We just start like, I'm not going in there. I don't know, no way am I going in there. It's nice and safe out here. I'm going to stay on this side. Or sometimes we ponder, maybe tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow I'll go through that. Because we're gripped with fear. Because we don't know what's on the other side of that door. And sometimes we linger before we go, and sometimes we allow our emotions to take over us and not allow us to enter through that door. Other times, help me here if you've been there. You have a friend or a mentor or somebody who either has to open the door for you or shoves you through it. Just go ahead. Sometimes it's a parent. Sometimes it's a grandparent. But we're constantly entering new doors. And as we grow along our walk, listening and asking questions, we become equipped with faith that we are not alone. See, every door that we enter is an opportunity for growth. Each time we enter a new door, transformation is going to take place. New relationships may take place. Sometimes we just don't know, but we have faith to enter the new door or the new season. Now, a couple things that I want to just reiterate and equip you with that you know when we go into this new season. First and foremost, God is faithful. Amen? God is faithful. We are never alone. We are never by ourselves. He never leaves us. He never forsakes us. He is always with us. Even when we're shoved through the doors, we are not alone. Just like Jesus was not alone in the scripture today. I'm going to remind you of Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he will make your path straight. So trust in the Lord, for he is there with you. Now, that's easier said than done, isn't it? If we look on this past year, how many times did we not think that God was with us? Maybe you were dealing with a tragedy, and you couldn't see God. saw God. So he's never, we're never alone. See, God is the light of the world. It's what happens most of the time when you enter into a new room or a new door. What do you do? Turn around the corner, hit that light switch, don't you? If we looked at that as something that we enter every day, and we are not alone, and we know that the light of the world, Jesus Christ, is with us, we should find comfort in that. We should know that even if the room is dimly lit, the light of the world is with us. Even if all we see is an itty-bitty little nightlight, the light of the world is with us. And so, and the light of the world lives within us. And so we can thus be the light to all the others in the world. So we know that God is faithful and that he is continually with us. Next thing I want to remind you of, as I lose my microphone, God is love. God is love. We love because God first loved us. So what if we entered every door this year, this coming year, with love as our focus? What difference would that make in this world if we entered, we stopped, and we said, you know what, I'm going to enter and I'm going to do things based in love. The door opens much easier when it's done with love. Think about how God loves us and he gave his one and only son for us. Now all that we do is based on love. Steve, can I have that slide? Have any of you seen this painting before? Jesus stands at the door and knocks. Have you noticed in this painting, there's no doorknob? Jesus is waiting for us to answer the door. And so this year, as we enter into a new phase, a new season, Jesus continually knocks on the door and wants us to come into a deeper relationship with him because he loves us and he wants us to know him better. And so he stands at the door and knocks. Do you open it? There is an itty-bitty little peephole thingy there. Maybe sometimes we have to look through the peephole, but the door still needs to be open. Sometimes we don't want to open the door because we know Jesus is there and Jesus is going to teach us, and sometimes that's not always so comfortable, is it? But remember, Jesus is love. And all that he does and all that he is based on love also. So let the love of Jesus teach us as we go through however we enter that door. If it be abruptly and fast, or sometimes we go in, okay, I didn't like that, I'm going to come back out of there, I don't want to go there. I mean, anybody done that? Oh, no, 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 I'm not going there. Not going there at all. And lastly, one of the things that I want to remind you of is, what kind of baggage are you taking with you through that door? I'm going to remind you, take the garbage out. Before you enter another door this season. All that hatred, anger, all of that resentment, judgment, criticalness, most of all of that unforgiveness. Leave it at the door. Don't enter the door this year carrying that baggage. It only weighs you down. And it makes your journey extremely hard. And so, once again, I'm going to reiterate unforgiveness. So first and foremost, how many times is it hard to forgive ourselves? How many times do we carry that within ourselves? Oh gosh, I can never forgive myself. I said this, I said that. He grew. He grew and he came into this world to save us from all of our sins. He died for us to save us from all our sins. So if he can forgive us, we need to reach down deep inside and bring that to God and say, God, forgive me. I want to forgive myself. Help me to forgive myself. And then we need to be able to forgive others. That's a tough one. You know, we said God is love. Doesn't God tell us to love? But our enemies, thanks, God. I really don't want to love our enemies. I want to carry bitterness and unforgiveness and judgment. I want to carry that. It's easier to be able to say something bad or mean or be regretful and hold it on, because you know what? It feels pretty good when it deals right there in the bottom of my stomach. It fills my gut up with something at least. Yuck! Get rid of it. Forgive others, whatever that is. You will have a much lighter load going forward. And thirdly, allow the other person to forgive you. And that doesn't necessarily have to be a verbal recognition. Allow it to occur. Allow it to happen. Don't carry it. Don't leave it at the doorstep. What do we say unforgiveness is? It's like what? Drinking poison and waiting for the other person to die. It doesn't make any sense. Let it go. Give it to God. Open the door. Jesus is standing right there. Hand it to him. Hand it all to him. He wants us to live in forgiveness as he has taught us. So as you enter this time and opportunities that await us as we enter these new doors, let us remember we are always in the Father's just like Jesus was, in the Father's house. God is a creator of all. God is in everything, and in everything that we do, and in everywhere. We are never alone. He will never leave us and never forsake us. And so we can enter those doors. We can face this new season. Let us find courage and help, and allow Jesus to help us go through whatever we need to this year. Remember what we had went through, we remember what we faced, and we continue to go through door after door after door to remember and to be able to do it with courage and love and faith, because we know that Jesus is with us. He may be beside us, he may be, you know what? Maybe Jesus is the one who's nudging us through that door. Maybe, just maybe, he knows what is best, and that he's always with us and never alone. So as we enter these doors, let us do it with passion, excitement, and joy to know who we are and who God is. And whatever lies behind those doors, we know that Jesus leads the way also. We go, today when you go home, you're going to enter a room. You're going to open a door. You're going to go through a doorway. And I want you to think about that life. turn on that light switch. Because he's always with us. He is the light of the world. He illuminates all that we do and all that we are. And you know what? Sometimes it's scary. It is just downright scary to open that next door. But we know that God is with us. And you know what? What if we sat in the awe and the wonder of what God is going to reveal to us as the door swings open? Are you ready? Are you ready to enter that door? Couple things you want to do. Maybe you need to straighten out the welcome mat. Sure, it's nice and pretty. You know, if you need to, if you're one who likes signs, go ahead and put a sign on your door that says, for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Whatever it is that it takes, let us not approach this door of this new year with any kind of fear, but with faith. Let us pray. Gracious and glorious God, we thank you. We thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ. That, Lord, we are never alone. That his light shines so bright before us, but also in us, Lord. And so, Lord, let us be that light as we enter all the doors this year in our lives. Just like Jesus entered a new season. Lord, we await what you have for us. Lord, we praise you. We love you. And God, when you stand at the door and you knock, we will open the door with joy and thanksgiving. And all God's people said, so now let us stand and let us sing about God's faithfulness.